Hello everyone, good afternoon. I'm Prasoon Agarwal from EQ International Magazine, and today I have the pleasure to be here with Mr. Kartik Sachdeva, who is the head of solar products at Su-Kam Solar. Hi Kartik.
Hi Prasoon.
First of all, I would just like to begin to have an introduction about Su-Kam Solar and what products and services does it offer in the Indian solar market.
So I would give you a brief about Su-Kam. So it had started in 1998 and mostly focused on the power backup solutions. So we are known for the reliable and quality products of the inverter segment, of the power backup inverters and batteries. And back in 2004, we centered in the solar industry. And since then, we are making many solutions which are relevant to Indian market. Many home lighting systems we have made, and we have participated in many tenders, government tenders. Wherein there was no electricity, and we gave the solution in which you can run a fan and two lights for 2 days with only a single panel, a complete DC solution, and solutions like off-grid systems. Because in India still we feel 30% of the population is living without electricity in our country, and that is a big market for us. So we are very much focused on the off-grid market, and we have a good hold in that market. And in off-grid, the solution that we're looking for is a reliable solution. So we have all the product range from off-grid to on-grid and hybrid inverters that we have launched here in InterSolar, and the street lighting solutions, inverter, battery. So we have more than 200 products, and currently in India we have more than 30,000 channel partners working with us, and we have a global presence also across about 80 countries. We are exporting right now made in India power backup products. Yes.
Kartik, can you also share some business numbers with us as to how much products have you supplied in the Indian market till now, and what is the current pipeline?
So in the solar segment, I would say we are not into like big projects. We are mostly into residential and commercial. And till now we have crossed about 100 megawatt. I mean, it's not like 2 megawatt into 50 sites. It's like 2 kilowatt into thousands and lakhs of sites. So we are more into numbers, small wattage, but more numbers, dealing directly with the end customer. So our target and our vision is also to take the solar to every household, each household, and so that a common man can utilize the power of sun and contribute into the environmental factor. Yeah.
What is your view on the rooftops market right now? I mean, out of the 100 gigawatt target also, there's 40% given to rooftops. So how do you see that? Is the industry equipped to achieve that target?
So definitely the target has increased from 20 to 100 gigawatt first of all, and it's a visionary target. If you take a bigger target, we would reach somewhere around and rooftop, I would say 15 or 20 gigawatts, which is still a bigger number which was there with the previous government. So this government is very active and talking about solar on various platforms, as our Prime Minister has gone to Paris and has spoken about the potential of the solar countries that we have, and they've made international solar alliance. So see, since the leader of the country is talking about solar, so definitely we feel there's a good awareness, and there's a good demand coming up, especially in rural areas where there is no power, and taking power to the rural is very difficult. So we are there as a company. We have dealers, distributors in rural of part of the country, and they are awaring the customers, awaring the dealers with our solar solutions. And also we have made many YouTube videos, as you see the videos running, it's about how the solar works. So we are taking the platform of online digital media, as we see in rural also everybody is now having a smartphone and internet connectivity. So we are making many videos on how to train people, how to install solar, what are the services you can get from the solar, benefits of the solar, if you want to repair your solar system, how to repair. So we have a YouTube channel of a 40,000 subscriber base till now, and some of our videos, I see a video that we uploaded on DC system, it has crossed more than 10 lakh views. So the end customer is want to go to solar, he just wants the right partners. So we are there with the right products and right placement. So see, a government for the rooftop, it is very difficult for the government to get the data, because it is installed at in a very remote areas, and government can only get the data which is happening in commercial 100 kilowatt or 500 kilowatt. But if a small customer like you and me, we install a 500 watt or a 1 kilowatt, this data doesn't go to the government. So I feel the number that we are having of 8 gigawatts, I still feel it's a very partial number. The amount is much more which has already installed in India, and I see a very bright future because the target is very big. So government is also trying its level They have some subsidy schemes which are running, but see, more than the subsidy, it is about the customers. If the end consumer sees the benefit, he will go with the solar, and it is very important for, you know, environmental also to go solar. Yeah,
Kartik, something on the technology front, what sort of technological innovations is Su-Kam into, and any, can you also share some details if you have prepared, if you have made any indigenous product specifically for the Indian market?
So what we face in rural area, I'm saying rural many times, it's because the major consumption story is happening in rural of our country. And if you go in a rural area, the voltage is a very big problem. I mean, in India, grid condition, our neutral is very weak. So, you know, we have to make the systems which are very reliable in, you know, Indian grid condition, where voltage can go as low as 90 volts. So our inverters are can run, you know, even at 90 volts. Otherwise, you know, the inverter coming from Europe and Chinese inverter, they stop at 180 volts. They stop functioning because they're designed for European conditions or a Chinese condition. But our Indian condition is quite different. So we have made those products which can work in a, you know, a bad grid condition, I could say. And see, if government is trying its level best to electrify the villages, but then still in electrification, it's not, you know, 100% the village is electrified. Some percentage is electrified and some is still facing the power shortages. So we have those products which are, you know, for those customers. So we have Greta inverters, which is a galvanic isolation based. So Greta also, there's a problem with Chinese and imported inverters. So they get their capacitors burned or their IGBTs burned only because the voltage gets inside the, you know, high voltage gets inside the inverter and it burns the inverter. And imported players don't have the services right now here in India. And where we as a company, Su-Kam, we have service center across India and in our remote areas as well. So we have designed inverters as a transformer with the galvanic isolation. So the benefit of the galvanic isolation is if there is, you know, voltage coming back, it protects your inverter. So we are making those inverter which are, you know, which will run for 5 years, 10 years at least, because the panel warranty is for 25 years. And you take an inverter, imported inverter, which is, let's say, it's still expensive. The imported inverters are expensive, but still people are, you know, installing those inverters because they don't have the awareness. So we have made a, you know, inverters which are good for Indian conditions, and we're just trying to create the awareness as much as possible through YouTube videos, through exhibition like these, through your medium, to, you know, install made in India Greta inverters which are reliable and which is helping, you know, Indian economy. Instead of getting our inverters from outside, we should make our inverters in India and should export our inverters. Yes.
Just one last question, Kartik. I would like to have your comments on the general business environment in the solar Indian solar industry right now. How has been the policy and regulatory regime, the sort of competition which you are facing, the impact of ever decreasing tariffs? So what are your views on that?
So once again, I would say when we talk about solar, we take a very big picture, like about the tariff or, you know, per watt. And we as a company, as we are working in a, you know, on the field, on the this thing, on the ground reality is completely different, because who is installing solar is mostly what we see as a company is a person who is not getting proper electricity for, you know, 7 hours, 8 hours, and he's not able to charge his batteries. So there he's installing the panels and getting the charge. And you see, especially for the areas where people are using gensets, so to produce electricity per unit from genset, it costs you around somewhere 18 rupees. So on those places, if you install solar, your return on investment will be as low as 1 year, because your amount of rupees that you saved is 18 rupees per unit. So in an area where there is a lot of you know, power cut, rural areas, everywhere in the state there is some rural areas where there is a lot of power cut, and people installing off-grid solutions. And as per a tariff is concerned, I mean, there are a lot of companies who are making solar parks and everything, but we are mostly into getting the solar into residential, to the houses, to the offices, to the commercial buildings, and try to, you know, because it is coming down only. I mean, the ROI, remember, 3 years back was somewhere around 6 to 7 years on an on-grid system, and now it has come down to as low as 3 years. So definitely, I mean, it is improving. Yeah.
So, Kartik, I mean, distributed solar is of course very important, seen in the Indian solar industry, and I believe that Su-Kam will definitely have an important role to play in that. Thank you so much for your time. That was a really nice opportunity speaking with you. Thanks, Kartik.
Thank you so much for the interview. Thanks, Kartik.